Hello and welcome to this feature preview of state encryption planned for OpenTofu 1.7. This is a longer video explaining the details of why you would need state encryption, how to configure it, how to change your keys, how to set up encryption using environment variables, how encryption affects your external tooling you may be using, and where to get more information in case you're interested. If you would like a quicker overview, please check out the 1 minute short we also uploaded. Let's get started with the reasons and use cases for state encryption. Imagine you're using OpenTofu to create an access key for your cloud provider that you want to use for an application. When you use a resource block to create an access key, OpenTofu stores the access key in its state file. OpenTofu and its predecessor Terraform historically stored the state file unencrypted, which presents a risk of someone with access to the state file storage stealing your secrets stored in it. OpenTofu can store state files as well as execution plan files locally on your hard drive, but it can also store it on a backend, such as an S3 object storage. Additionally, you can also use the Terraform remote state data source to read state files from other projects, which is useful when you have a larger infrastructure. However, unless your backend supports server-side encryption, your state data is always unencrypted, which is where OpenTofu state encryption comes in. With state encryption, you can provide OpenTofu with an encryption key either locally or using a key management system such as AWS KMS, GCP Secret Manager, or Azure Key Vault. OpenTofu will then use this encryption key to encrypt your state and plan files. Because OpenTofu performs the encryption on the client side, a potential attacker must gain access to both the state file storage and the encryption key to read its secrets, giving you an additional layer of protection. While the exact details might still change until the final release, let's go through what it would take to configure state encryption in your OpenTofu project. First, you will need to create an encryption block in the Terraform block. Inside this block, you will need to specify at least one key provider. In this example, we are showing a key provider that simply accepts a hex-encoded encryption key. As a next step, you will have to select an encryption method you want to use. Once we release this feature, please read the documentation on what encryption method is suitable for your specific use case, as this may vary depending on how large your state file is and how many plan and apply runs you intend to run per day. In the configuration, you will have to link your key provider to your encryption method, as shown in this example, but you may want to customize other settings for the method too. Finally, you need to select your intended encryption target. In this example, the target is the state file stored locally on your computer. You need to link the target to the method you just created. Of course, in addition to the local state file encryption, you can also configure plan file encryption or backend encryption in the same way. When it comes to remote state data sources, you can specify encryption in a separate remote state block. Here you can either select a default encryption method for all remote state data sources or individually for each data source. If feasible, we recommend setting up separate encryption keys for each project. Before we move on, a few notes on what we discussed so far. First of all, the encryption setting is global. Currently, there is no way for module authors to provide a prepackaged encryption setup. This is a limitation we may address in a future version of OpenTofu if there is enough community demand. Second, encryption protects the state and plan data at rest. The TOFU commands dealing with the state data, such as JSON output, show, or plan, will not encrypt their output. These commands will work exactly as they did before. Please note that encryption currently does not protect against replay attacks. It only protects against unauthorized access. This means that an attacker with access to your plan file storage could replace the current plan file with an old one. If you then run the old plan file, it may cause harm in your infrastructure. You can mitigate this risk by rotating encryption keys frequently using your key management system, for example, daily. This brings us to the next chapter in this video, which is key and method rollover. OpenTofu state encryption supports the seamless transition from one encryption key and method to another. Inside your intended encryption target block, such as the state file block in this case, you can specify a fallback block, referencing your old encryption method. If OpenTofu fails to read your state with the new encryption method, it will automatically read with the fallback method. If OpenTofu modifies the state file, it will also resave it with the new method. Importantly, you should also use fallback methods when you want to rename a key provider or method in the chain. This is because the encrypted state or plan files contain some metadata linked to the key provider and method names that are required for decryption. As a best practice, treat your encryption configuration as immutable. If you change something, use a fallback block. To help with changing the configuration easily, we are also adding the ability to configure encryption using an environment variable. You can supply any of the configurations you have previously seen using the TF encryption environment variable. As OpenTofu supports configuration in both OpenTofu code format and the JSON format, you can use either in the environment variable. If you want to use JSON, you can find the description of the JSON format in the OpenTofu documentation under the title JSON Configuration Syntax. If you want to use environment variables to configure your encryption, but you're worried that someone might forget them, resulting in unencrypted data, there is an additional option called Enforce. You can put this option into your file-based configuration to make sure that OpenTofu never writes your state or plan file without encryption and returns an error to the user if they fail to provide an encryption configuration. Finally, let's talk about external tooling and when you can start using encryption in OpenTofu. When you use external tooling, but you don't enable encryption, nothing will change. Every command will continue to work as before. Even if you do enable encryption, the JSON output, which most external tools use, will not change. On the other hand, if your external tool accesses the state and plan files directly without calling OpenTofu, these tools will not work with encrypted files. The tool authors will need to embed a Go library, which we plan to publish later. If you're a tool author, please note that we are currently not standardizing the encrypted format. You should not attempt to implement your own encryption and decryption routines, as the format may change in the future. The encryption feature is currently planned for OpenTofu 1.7 and the potential Go library for OpenTofu 1.8 when we have gathered enough feedback from the community. If there's enough interest from the community for writing custom key providers and encryption methods, we may also expose this functionality through a plugin API at a later date. If you would like to get more information on upcoming features, please join our weekly engineering sync on Wednesdays. You can also reach us via the OpenTofu Slack and GitHub discussions. The current state encryption technical documentation is available in the main OpenTofu repository on GitHub in the docs folder. Please let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we will try to answer them as soon as possible. Thank you for listening, and have a wonderful day.